And now, live from Hollywood, California, all the way from Smokesylvania, it's the Count Smokula Show.
I like rap. She likes Rhapsody.
Bring out the map. Let's find some harmony.
Relax. There's no place to go. Come to the Count Smokula Show. Hillbilly. Look at the clock.
It's that time, you silly bean.
Relax, there's no place to go. Come to the Count Smokula Show. We have surprises.
We have guests.
We only have the very best.
Opinions to get off our chest.
So on, with the floor.
Ladies and gentlemen, you did it again. You turned into the most fascinating talk show in the entire world, the Count Smokula Show. I, of course, am Count Smokula, your host, and this, of course, is the Spectacular Susi, my most beloved co-host, Spectacular Susi. How are you tonight, darling?
I feel very loved.
That's
right. I feel fabulous.
You feel fabulous? Why do you feel fabulous?
Because we have some great guests tonight. I can't wait.
We do. We have great guests today. We have tonight, today, whenever you're watching. Sometimes you watch in the early morning, sometimes in the middle of the afternoon, and sometimes in the late of the night. You never know when you're watching. We got great guests like you wouldn't believe. We have the Michael Butler. The great Michael Butler produced the musical. That's right, Hair. That's right. And we have the great movie star, John Phillip Law. Can you believe this? Ladies and gentlemen out there, we have these people on our humble show.
I have to tell you something about John Phillip Law.
Please.
Does everybody remember Barbarella?
There was
an angel in Barbarella. And when that man came on the screen, I said, he's not handsome, he's not pretty, he was beautiful.
And the way he flew, you wouldn't believe it. Better than a chicken.
Listen to him, the way he flies.
Yeah, like an eagle.
I'm talking about beautiful.
The man can fly. I couldn't believe it. I'd never seen a human being with wings before, but this guy convinced me that a human being could grow wings and fly all over the earth. And you know what? If Jane Fonda was in my arms, I would be flying too. But he did it. He did a great job, and we're really honored.
I can see that.
To have him on the program today. Susi, as you know, of course, the Spectacular Susi is one of the greatest volleyball players in the entire world. And this is why she feels so good today. One of the reasons, because she actually played today. I put money on the game. I didn't tell her. And did you win?
Two games.
I won two because the Spectacular Susi won the volleyball. How many? What was the point spread?
Well, I think it was 15 to 12 and 15 to 13.
This is good. I think I won about 50 cents. I'm not a big bettor, but I like to play the balls.
He's really fun in Las Vegas, I'll tell you.
That's right, in Vegas with the roulettes. Now, they're already running from the time.
Nickel machines.
The nickels, the quarters, the whole deal. We are running from the time because normally we talk a little longer, but today, because of this special guest, we want them to express themselves like they've never expressed themselves before. So we're going to get right down to business.
Yeah.
The first aspect of the business, of course, being the Count Smokula's major affirmations, which all of you at home always help us with. And you're going to help us with it right now. And the people
nice
also in the studio audience, our dear friends, will help us with today's major affirmations. Yeah. I found this. This was inspired by my dear friend, the artist philosopher again, Mr. Patrick Morrison, who always has something deep to say. So, he tells me that the biggest problem in his life, as in my life, is this. And I will not
Distract myself or spin my wheels needlessly.
Let's do it again.
Faster.
I will get it on our head.
I will not distract myself or spin my wheels needlessly.
This is great. We could do it a third time, but I don't think we will. Now, if we can just do this in normal day living. Every day there's something comes up all the time. The phone rings. Sometimes, for example, you'll be sitting around trying to accomplish something. Mm-hmm. I tried to accomplish something once, and the phone rang, and I never got off the phone, and so I accomplished nothing. But now if I could get the phone to ring, the phone would tell me not to pick itself up. I think I don't have the phone ringer in the anywhere. Oh, there it is. The phone is ringing. As you can hear,
I heard it.
You can hear the phone, but I will not pick up the phone because I will not distract myself needlessly. Okay, now.
He's doing his own philosophy.
I know.
I wish I could do that.
One of those things that when you experiment with the mind plays tricks on you and makes it work better. Okay. This is a smokularism. I learned this from the people back home in Smokesylvania. I learned this from my grandmother in Glipsch in Smokesylvania. Now. But I want to tell you.
Oh, the Bible.
We have to do a reading from the Bible.
The Bible.
You ready?
Mm-hmm.
The Weekly World News.
He lives by this Bible.
I do because I believe in it. Mm. Everything they say here could be true. Now, this part, normally I am a fearless fellow.
Mm-hmm.
As you know. As you know, I fear nothing.
I do.
But there's one thing they showed in the Weekly World News this week scared the bejesus out of me. Look at this. Show it in the monitor. The escaped bat boy was sighted at a stock car race. He's in Charlotte, North Carolina. He's growing. The last time he was seen, he was 2 feet tall. Now he's like 4 feet. He weighs a lot of pounds, and he's everywhere. Listen, people, I will pick up the phone if you call me about the bat boy. If you see the bat boy, I will know from my psychic phenomenon that was programmed in the mind as a youth in Glipsch in Smokesylvania. I will know the callers about that. I will pick it up. And that will be it. Okay, look, the bat boy had no hair.
Oh.
We got something real quick. I got something because the scary people,
got?
The Count Smokula's ultra quick hair growth formula. Where's the Bruce?
Where's the Bruce? Quick, be careful.
What's the matter? Hurry, Bruce.
Never know what
we got
happens
a guy
to this
from
guy.
The audience. We saw the poor fella. Sit down. Look at this. Look,
what
can we get a close up of this poor head? Look, there's nothing, not much growing. They're going to take the Count Smokula's. Uh-huh. They're going to ultra quick hair growth formula. Sometimes you need hair in an emergency. And the show, by the way, is about hair because we got the producer of hair, Mr. Michael Butler, is coming up soon. We love it. Now, show in the monitor real quick. You can buy this. So for $39.99, you just send your checks and money orders here to the Count Smokula Show.
Oh, I think I see it's
anywhere
working.
Anywhere you like. They know where we are.
Gosh.
In Hollywood of the California.
Oh, my God.
Look
gosh
at this. Look how quick the hair growth formula
works.
I told you.
Word.
I told you it works. Now get lost. Look at this poor schnook. Now go to a party. Go have a good time. Impress the girls. Let's see a clip from the great movie. This is one of the greatest movies I ever seen in my life. But it was started out as a play. It was Hair. That Michael Butler found
that
a play in New York City.
Love that.
In the Shakespeare Festival. He brought it onto Broadway. Turned it into the most successful touring play in history, 29 road companies of the hair. And then they made a movie. Let's see the clip and bring up Michael Butler. This is from the end of Hair. Come on,
hair.
Come on. Show that clip. and gentlemen, but I found out right during that clip that the Spectacular Susi was a hippie, and she was probably in the movie. You know what we have right here? I promised, and I did deliver the goods.
I love that.
Mr. Michael Butler, welcome to our humble show.
Yes.
It's really a pleasure. This man has done just about everything a human being can do in life, and now he's on the Count Smokula Show, and it's such a pleasure for us to have you here.
That's the ultimate occasion.
Michael. We're thrilled.
I have to tell you something. When Hair came out, my father told me if I would see that film or go to the play, he would disown me.
Well, that's the first thing I did. I went and saw that film.
Susie, she was a hippie rebel. And Michael probably started the whole hippie rebel business all over the earth.
Oh, yes, that was very exciting.
It was an exciting fun. Tell us about this, how you found this Hair people and made this
big.
Success.
Well, I was in New York working on the Civil Rights Commission with Kerner, the governor of Illinois, and I saw in the New York Times an ad for Hair, the American tribal love rock musical, and I thought it was an Indian show. Mm. And so I went down to the first preview and discovered that it was not an Indian show, and I was getting ready to run for the U.S. Senate at that time. And I said, I'd like to take this show to Illinois and show it to my constituents. This is what I think of the war, and this is how I felt about the whole business of freedom. Hair is more about freedom than anything else. Well, anyway, make a long story short, Joe Papp said, no, we don't do that. A couple of days later, he called me in Illinois, and he said, well, would you like to co-produce it? And I said, yes, I'd love to. So I left Chicago, came to New York, co-produced it, didn't work out. I took on the first class rights myself, brought in a new director, and did some changes that we wanted to make, and off it went.
And it became the most successful show in the history of the world.
Yeah,
it's 29 road companies in every major country.
Yeah, true.
Every place. True. And they was playing the Hair for years and years.
I love it.
10 years later,
right,
they make the movie with the name Mr. Michael Butler, the producer.
Right.
Now, Michael, you did so many other things. I want to take a trip with you down memory lane by giving you some voids, some names, some things. You can talk about it. Expostulations. Okay. Tyrone Power. What this means to you?
My godfather.
This was a great movie star.
Yeah. He was one of the most beautiful men that ever walked. He was a very great actor and a very serious actor. And just wonderful memories, a wonderful man.
Okay, this is great. I have another one. The Juke Savages of Truces, New Mexico.
That's how I met John Phillip Law.
Oh.
That's right.
Right after the convention in 68 in Chicago, I was with Peter Yarrow.
Peter, Paul, and Mary.
Yeah. Right. And Peter and I had done a movie together called You Are What You Eat.
Why not?
And it's true.
Yes, of course.
And so we were blown away by what happened at the convention and all that. And Peter said, we've got to get out of town. And he said, I have a very good idea. He said, there's some tremendous talent in New Mexico. And that talent is a man called Wavy Gravy. And so I said, we've got to go down and look at him. So,
Hugh Romney, I even know him.
Exactly.
A great guy.
We got Fred Reinglass, who was the production stage manager of Hair. We flew down to Albuquerque, chartered a plane, went up to Santa Fe, got out of the plane, rented a car, and Peter said, now on the way to see Wavy Gravy, Hugh Romney, I want to go by and visit a friend of mine called Tom Law, and who have a group called the Juke Savages, and they're in the mountains near Truches. So we go up there in the car and so forth, and we arrive just as this large tribe are getting ready to take a sacred rite of peyote dipped in psilocybin.
This sounds, what is this?
We remember those times, Yes,
Texas.
Oh, we better not talk about that. Okay.
We never got to see Wavy Gravy.
But it must have been a delicious piece.
That's how
what
I met John.
Now, how about this one? All right. Here's a name that's America would be amazed. JFK.
Oh, JFK. Well, he was a very close friend. I did a lot of work for him in the Middle East when he was a senator. Before then, we had sailed together a lot when he was a representative in Congress. And I did work for him he couldn't get a lot of information out of the embassies and things like that. So I did, I worked with Jack, and we had a wonderful time together, working-wise and fun-wise.
And we all know him as the great president of the United States.
Yeah, he was.
Yeah, he was.
Did you get in a lot of trouble together?
President.
Yeah, well, I had a lot of trouble with Jackie, because Jackie always thought that I was leading Jack astray.
Uh-huh. Oh, boy.
Was
oh.
The other
later,
way around?
Later on, she finally realized that he was leading me astray.
We could continue this for a long time, but we have another very special guest.
Uh-huh.
We have a great, great movie star. I told you about this. The man who was the angel in the Barbarella.
Your buddy.
That's your right. buddy, the man with the mushrooms and the this and the that and the cactus. And the man who came to Hollywood, conquered Hollywood, was in the Sinbad.
Oh, so smooth.
We're going to bring him up, but first, let's see the clip.
Yes.
From the acting voice, the world of John Phillip Law.
Beautiful.
And then we'll talk more.
Although he has starred in big-budget American films, John Phillip Law's greatest success has been abroad.
I've done more than 50 motion pictures now, and very few of them have been right here in Hollywood. I felt very lucky to be able to be successful in a career that has enabled me to go so many places and be an ambassador without portfolio in so many countries, and that's been a real blessing.
We will build the temple of our God.
Excuse me, Mr. Dobson, but my daddy would never forgive me if I didn't stop by and say hi. Hi.
Your daddy?
Hal Tompkins.
Hal Tompkins.
He cleans the fat drains at your meat plant in Snyder.
Well, isn't it a small world? Well, you be sure to say hi to your daddy for me.
One more citation, you're both going to the work farm.
That just don't seem fair at all to me.
Now, Harley, you know that this section of the forest is a game preserve. That means no hunting.
She's going to an island off Trinidad. It's called Tobago. We will be there for 8 weeks.
Son, send us a rung and you.
Boom, boom. I don't understand. Blanche and I, we together.
That will be enough.
Sorry.
You know, sometimes I just don't think I tell you often enough what inspiration you've been to me.
Now that means more to me than you'll ever know, Scott. I hope we can do this again real soon. Maybe in New York. Be sure to say goodbye to Christine for me, huh?
Well, we could always just...
What?
Well, your orders were to get him out of here or make sure he's dead, right? Shoot him, grab a fishing boat, and go.
No, it's not that easy to kill a man in cold blood. That's something you've got to live with.
I'm the nose.
Champagne.
This is the angel. This is not what you think, by the way, folks. This is Count Smokula's Liquid Lunch. John Phillip Law, it's a pleasure.
It's my pleasure. Yes. Nice to be with you, Count.
Some liquid lunch.
Nice to be with you.
Enjoy some liquid lunch.
Liquid lunch. Oh, thank you very
much. No coyote in there. No coyote.
Maybe. I think I'll abstain.
We don't know.
It's an old secret recipe from the Smokesylvania.
Smokesylvania.
The Grebs Brothers and Schmeckel Corporation in Smokesylvania.
That is coyote.
John Phillip Law, you're a real movie star, but I got to tell you, I've been dying to know this. How was it working with Jane Fonda?
Ooh.
Oh, my goodness. I knew Jane, actually, when I worked with her, I was living with she and Vadim for about a year because I'd worked with her in Hurry Sundown before that. That was an Otto Preminger film with Faye Dunaway playing my wife, and Jane was my sister, and Michael Caine was my evil uncle. So we knew each other, and that's how they got cast in Barbarella.
Well, they're showing this was Barbarella. Let's talk about that. Yeah, we got some pictures.
I've got to ask you something. You were just so beautiful. Now, did that ever hurt your career? Because you weren't handsome.
Well,
you were beautiful. Did that hurt your career?
You're not so bad looking yourself, honey.
Thank you.
This is the spectacular.
It always feels funny, but it's beautiful. I guess it's great. I mean, it's a big compliment. But. Well, I was always, you know, trying to be a little more like Arnie, you know, and I'm just kind of an ectomorph, you know. I could work out, and then if I stopped, I'd just go right back to.
He's skinny, but he's
not. I don't think it bothered any women, not a one.
No, it was good. Now let's look at some of the. John brought some of the pictures, some of the stills from his fabulous career. Let's talk about that. What is this one, John?
Oh, that's Danger Diabolik. That's become a kind of a cult classic. Yeah.
Mm,
in fact, that one just came out on the Laserdisc.
Let's see this in the Laserdisc. John has a copy. You can get this somewhere.
How many cult films do you have?
You can get this one from, I guess, from Tower Records.
Something.
Tower Video.
This is. Danger of Babylon. Let's see, but let's keep moving because we got so much material to cover.
Sinbad the Sinner?
Sinbad the Sinner. Sinbad. I love this movie.
This isn't Sinbad.
Yeah, that's Marisa Mell in Danger Diabolik there. Uh-huh. She is no longer with us, but she was a wonderful Austrian actress. We became quite friendly working together.
Does this happen often? Did you become quite friendly all the time?
Here's old Sinbad the Sinner.
That was very macho.
Golden voice.
This was great. This is also on the
That's another laser. We just did another one for England. I was with the director and Caroline Monroe, my co-star, and we did a track to go on the new English laser disc of what it's like 20 years later, talking about the film and what happened and all that. So.
This is great. And you're now going to the conventions and talking about the films and being the cult star.
Being a cult, a piece of pop art. Huh?
This is great. Well, this is, the film is the pop art of the 20th century.
Yeah.
All know that. What else? We got more pictures. Look at this one with a boy. A big boy.
Red Baron.
A falcon, an eagle.
That's a South African tawny eagle.
Uh-huh.
Big sucker, man. Right? It had about a 7-foot wingspread, that one.
Big
and are you adept in the handling of the
eagles? Well, you know, it's actors are adept at, you know, we're jack of all trades, master of none, and they're always teaching us to do something.
Pick it up and do it.
Yeah, some guy walks in and says, well, here, just put on the glove, hold the meat,
and then
I want you to just yell, and when he flies at you, don't duck, just hold your hand out there.
Look macho while you're holding him. Yeah.
That's right. Oh, boy. There are more pictures. I don't even know. This one. I love this.
Yeah. Oh, that's old Lee Van Cleve. That's a spaghetti western I did called Death Rides the Horse.
Oh, you have to have done a spaghetti western.
Yeah, that was a lot of fun.
Mm-hmm. Oh, boy. So what's next for John Phillip Law?
Well, I'm off to Europe again. I chase around Europe, and I did an Italian television series a couple of years ago where I played a colonel in the Guardia di Finanza, which was a lot of fun. That's the elite Italian border guard police, you know.
It must be great.
And I'm going to go back and I've got a project possibly. I may be going to North Korea to do an adventure film for a German-Italian company this fall, which should be a lot of fun.
This sounds like a blast.
Yeah. Yeah. Good guy or bad guy?
Good guy. I'm kind of stuck with the good guy roles. I have been. Yeah.
That's good because you're a good guy and a real good guy for coming
very nice
to the Count Smokula Show. You know, this is something special to these two gentlemen. Now we got the two gentlemen right here on the Count Smokula Show. We are running from the time, so I'm going to open the table up to our roundtable discussion. And the subject is the topic of today's subject. These gentlemen have lived through the interesting times and the big changes. What do you advise the youth in this troubled world of ours? I'm opening it up.
These guys should be
telling
us.
Here's your chance, Michael.
Uh-huh. Michael has a lot of
opinions. Getting into lots of trouble on both sides. Okay.
I think young people just have to realize that to go up, you have to go down. And you have to go for life in every possible sense. And it's really very good times in many ways. I feel it's the most important thing to do is to protect freedom. and the freedom to do what you want to do with your body, to do what you want to do with yourself, as long as you don't hurt anybody else. And
so it was a good call, this new legislation on the internet. Do you think that's a good call?
Very good call. Very good call. I mean, mm-hmm. Governments constantly over the centuries have been trying to cut down on freedom. It just makes it easier to run. If people will do what you tell them to do, it's easy to run the country. It's a very natural thing that they're trying to do.
And that's exactly what we're about here. The Count Smokula Show, health, happiness, and freedom.
Of speech.
Freedom of this and freedom of anything you like. Anybody, either of you.
Free love.
But that's it, free love.
Not anymore.
Oh,
my golly. That was the 60s.
The 60s. Over.
I like the 60s.
That was the 60s are the best period ever.
I must say, we had a lot of fun.
It wasn't
the death
duration.
Sentence in those days.
In the 60s, me personally, I was kind of old, so I didn't enjoy it like you guys. I'm 496. I've seen just about everything. I'm getting my new second wind. A revitalization, and I'm really enjoying your company here, of course, the Spectacular Susi. So I want to thank my guests, of course, Michael Butler.
Nice to be here.
And you live in Chicago, the great city. Hello, Chicago! The Spectacular Susi, of course, our lovely, delightful co-host. And the great John Phillip Law.
Yes.
Watch for his movies, his laser discs, his appearances and everything right now. But we're going to do is the Dance of Joy from Smokesylvania. Oh. I'm going to ask my guests, co-hosts, and all the members of our audience to jump up on stage. Come on. We got the delightful Christina, who brought these gentlemen
all right.
Amazing as it is.
Oh, good, good.
Yes, we'll be happy, be natural, and be free. Come on up here, and let's dance.
I can't do something like that. Hey,
to go. Come to the Count Smokula Show.
I like rock.
I like hillbilly. Look at the clock.
It's that time, you silly bee.
Relax, there's no place to go. Come to the Count Smokula Show. We have surprises.
We have guests.
We only have the very best
opinions to get off our